What's going on, too? Man, we're coming through with an update, man, on the Malibu. Finna go ahead and get the motor dropped in so we can get her moving and grooving, just so I'll be able to move around in the yard and clear out some space in my storage. Let me flip this camera around, show y'all where we at right now. It's dark outside. I just got home from work maybe like an hour ago. Dark caught me, but trying to just get something done while I can, man. Got my light out here. But got the motor out the storage. Transmission 4L60E right there, bust down for the 5.3 to go in the box Chevy. So we got the motor out. I don't got no concrete, so I have to use these little boards. But I'ma just push the Malibu. I don't know if y'all can see it that good. There she go. I'ma just push it over here and drop it in right here. I just need to move that other 5.3 right there out the way. I'm gonna stick it on the bed of the truck over there. I got a 400 transmission over there and a 200R. The 200R is what's gonna go behind here to go in the Malibu. I just gotta find a cross member next and she'll be ready. Got long tube headers to go on it. So we out here late night grinding, man. Just want to bring y'all along, show y'all where we at. I gotta change this flex plate. I got another one. This came a couple of the teeth on the chip. That's why I was just using it as a test one, just to crank the motor over. But yeah, man, this is a 350 Vortec with the Summit 8802, which got the same similar specs as the LT4 cam. So you can call it that. Same, pretty much same thing. So y'all just stay tuned, man. It's nighttime right now. I'll probably just get the Malibu over here, get it ready to be dropped in, and I'll drop it in the morning or when I get some daylight. I just want to get myself set up, so all I got to do is slide it in the car and be done with it. So y'all stay tuned, and I'll be back. Hold tight. YouTube. We back, man. Making more progress on the Malibu. We finna go ahead and get the motor and transmission dropped in. I'm gonna show y'all that in a second. Just showing y'all how I'm doing it. Just don't know where I want to continue with it from here. Once I just want to get it running, and then I'm gonna push this to the side and jump on the Caprice. That way, all this did was just make storage. Got it out the engine stand. Got the 5.3 right here. It's gonna be going in the box. So just making some storage out my shed unit, man. Trying to get rid of some stuff that I know ain't serving me no purpose right now. And if I can recuperate some money out of it, that's what I'm gonna do. So y'all just stay locked in, stay tuned in, man. Yeah. So I got the motor and the transmission, made it together. See, I got the car right there. I'm out here on the board. I don't have concrete yet. So gotta improvise, do what I do. Got my engine hoist right there. I'm gonna swing it right here in the front and just pull the car forward and drop it on the frame. So motor and transmission, it's a 204R, and it does come with lockup. Easy way to hook up lockup. If yours is like a 87 and above, might even be 86, you tie these two wires here together that are parallel to one another, and that'll ground it, and you just get this 12 volt key power when the brakes is not being pressed. And then when the brakes is pressed, it'll kill the 12 volts and it'll take it out of lockup. And then as soon as you let on the brake, it'll put it back in lockup. So you can pretty much just tie this to your brake switch, and that'll make your converter lockup. So yeah, man, that's what we got here. Everything locked in. I just got to get another dipstick, but I can put that in while it's in the car. I ain't worried about that. But yeah, that's where we at with it. I got the dry shaft right there. So we finna go ahead and get this in here. I was gonna wash the frame off, but I ain't worried about it. It is what it is at this point. I just want to get it in the car. So we got a, this transmission was rebuilt. The guy bought it from, I guess whenever they did it, it was back in 2008, and the car had just been sitting. So, like I said, he let me get it for a core charge, so I went tripping on it. I'm going to try it out and see. If not, I got a built $700 for it right there. So, either way, it had an overdrive. I'll just have to swap the transmission, but that won't be too big of a deal. So this is what we're finna do now. We're finna get this in here, get it in there. So y'all just stay tuned. Make sure y'all like, share, comment, and subscribe, man. We're coming through with the Malibu. Finna get it going, cause we got the, I gotta do an update. I finally got my Posi rear end for the 91 Caprice over there. So we're gonna get her back on the road. And then I gotta start on the bill for the box Chevy. I got my OL60E right here for it. I already tore it down, checked all the parts. Mainly just gonna replace the sunshell, my rear planetary gear, Corvette servo, get some Ray Besto performance red clutches, and the Z-Pack for the 3-4 clutch pack. And that's pretty much it, man. And then just get the pump checked out. And that's all I'm gonna pretty much do to make it a little bit better than stock. And then we're gonna get this cleaned up so we can get it dropped in the box Chevy. So y'all stay tuned, man. Make sure y'all like, share, comment, definitely subscribe to the channel. Y'all stay tuned in, man. We're coming through with these bills. So once we get this in here, one other thing I got to find is a cross member. So I'm gonna be on the hunt for that. The cross member and the gear selector for the column that attaches to the side of the transmission right there, that arm. I gotta find that arm. But those are little small stuff. I'll probably just jump on eBay or hit up my local yard and see what's up. But y'all stay tuned, man. Next clip, she'll be sending to Malibu. Peace. We back, baby. Y'all see the motor is in, 350 Vortec with the LT4 Summit brand, 8802 part number. Roller cam, full roller motor, went all the way through everything in it, put it all back together. Just mounted on the frame, got the motor mount bolts going through on each side. So she in there. I just gotta get some water pump gaskets, thermostat gaskets, hook up the PCV valve, put a carb on it. Next thing, I gotta get a cross member. I'm actually finna try to go see if I can source one out right now. If not, I'll probably just get on Jegs or something and order one with the dual, because I got long tube headers that I'm going to sit on here. But yeah, man, she in there. So we're making progress. I'm probably just going to leave it right here for the day. I'm finna check out this cross member. Not too far from me, got one. Same guy I bought the transmission from, he had one. I think he had a... it was in a car that had a 400 in it. So a 400 and a 200 use the same cross member. So that shouldn't be no problem. I may go get it, let him see if he'll let me get it, bring it home. If it works for me, I'll buy it. If it doesn't, I'll just bring it back to him. Hopefully he'll let me do that, because I don't want to buy it and then it ain't no good to me. That's wasted money. I mean, I could always sell it and recuperate, but still, I don't want to go through that. I'd rather just go ahead and buy something I know that's going to work, so I can move forward. Cause once I get that and get the front clip on, man, we'll be good to go. But I ain't gonna be in a rush to put the front clip on, cause I wanna paint the inside of the fender wells. I already done primed them. So I'm painting the inside of the fender wells and the dough jams. I'm going with the dark gray green color that come on the 90s, the Impala SS's, the 95 or 96. That's the color I'm gonna paint the car. I had the same gray interior, get that redone. If I end up keeping the car by the time I get to that stage, if it's sold by then, cool. If not, either way, I ain't pressed about it. It's just giving me something to do. But the motor and transmission is in the Malibu, man. She locked in there ready. I gotta still do something with this alternator. It don't quite line up, so I just need to open that hole up just a little bit. Or just get a thinner bolt to go through there and put a nut on it. I probably just do that. That way I ain't got to mess up that bracket. But yeah, man, that's pretty much it. And she in there. We're going to get everything hooked up pretty soon and get all going. Probably got to find a different compressor to put on here, because that thing been sitting out. And it's, I know it's going to make noise. I just put the AC delete thing on it probably. But for the most part, yeah, man, that's it, man. She in here. Everything lines up like it need to. I'll probably bend this line. up and out the way like that. And bolt this in. Bam. And then I'm gonna return from right here to right there. From here to there. Power steering to be done. And everything. Coolant. Hook everything up. Pretty solid. I'm gonna go through on the wires on here too. See, it's been sitting out. Some of these wires are not in the best shape, so I'm gonna cut it to where I see it's good, and then just solder it, this tip back on there, so it'll go in the distributor like it needs to. For any of them that's like that, I think the power wires with these fusible links on them, I'm gonna see about getting some more. Cut it right here, get another fusible link, put it in there. That way I can make sure I got all good source power coming from all of them. So yeah, that's pretty much it, man. So we're gonna test fit the long tube headers on here, make sure they go on cross member, and we're gonna keep moving forward, man. Stay tuned, man. The motor is in the Malibu. Make sure y'all like, share, comment, and subscribe. And man, if y'all got cars out there y'all working on, man, just be patient. Be patient with yourself. Don't get caught up in the hype. You know, everything ain't got to be LS swap. Everything ain't got to be conventional. I mean, you do what works for you, you know. You ain't putting your car together to please somebody else. You putting it together for yourself, for your own fulfillment and enjoyment. Not to say, oh, I outdid the next person, because you will never outdo nobody. It's always going to be somebody out there got it better than you, got it more than you, got it more plentiful than you. And then you got people who don't even have what you have. So just be grateful for where you at, what you got. And man, as long as you content with that and God see that, man, he can bless you with more. That's like tithing. You know, a lot of people have a misconception about tithing, because they think it's, oh, I'm just giving my money to a organization or whatever. Nah, that's God's way of testing you, testing your integrity, and seeing if he can trust you, and can you manage what I have given you. That's all he's doing. And if he can see that you can do that, that's why it says in Malachi 3:10, try me and see, and won't I open up the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing you won't have room enough to receive. That's if you do what he told you to do. So y'all stay blessed, man. Keep your heads up, stay locked in on your projects, keep grinding. And shout out to I got another video coming up. Shout out to Willie Rebuilds. And it's a guy named Will's Workshop on Electric Fans. Willie Rebuilds showed what he got his from Current Performance on his Monte Carlo build he doing for Rat Nest. I'm gonna probably try that same harness on here with some electric fans, and probably use the BMW temp switch as the ground signal, because it has an on and off at like 180 and then 195. So that can act as a ground, like the computer would send the trigger, so it'll do the same. And that way I can run electric fans on here to cut on and off like it need to. So shout out to Willie Rebuilds for that. And then also Will's Workshop, he did the one that come off the actual Silverado trucks, where you can get it, like the LS trucks, whether it's a Tahoe, Suburban, Silverado, GMC, whatever. If it comes with electric fans, you can pull that standalone harness off of there and just tie it to whatever fans you want to run it to, and it works. Simple. I went and got one out the yard the other day for like $30. So, you know, that's another way you can go about it. So shout out to them guys. I'm going to bring a little bit of that knowledge over here to this video too, because they showed me a way. So I'm going to show it to the rest of y'all, the ones that view me. And if y'all ain't subscribed to their channels, man, y'all go check them out. Like I say, man, y'all keep y'all heads up. Do y'all thing. Like, share, and subscribe on the videos. And I'll bring y'all further along when we get a little further ahead on the build. So y'all stay locked in, stay tuned in, man. Peace.